The 10th principle of self-made millionaires is that they have high levels of energy, or as Tony Robbins says, a peak state. Everything around us is energy, and the more you give, the more you receive back. Self-made millionaires have these high levels of energy one way or another. A great example is rock stars. They're in a peak state and bring their high levels of energy over in their music and through their live concerts. Because they are able to change so many people's states, they get rich in the process. People love to be around people that make them happy and put them in a peak state as well. To create a peak state, it is very important to get enough rest at night. First of all, sleep at regular times and wake up at the same time every day. 7 to 8 hours is optimum according to research. Go to bed around 10 p.m. and wake up at 6 a.m. Another advantage of this is that most people are still asleep at 6, which gives you a few hours for yourself to read or to finish an important task. A nap in the afternoon of about 30 minutes is a great way to process the morning and to recharge your batteries for the afternoon session. Secondly, do some sort of physical exercise as soon as you wake up. Go outside and go for a walk, get on your rebounder, or even better, go for a run or go to the gym and work out. This is a great way of starting your day. Thirdly, drink more water. Especially if you work hard throughout the day and you feel tired, this is usually a sign of dehydration. Drink at least a glass of water every hour or more, depending on your personal needs. And fourthly, make your life more fun. Play your favorite music at work. Enjoy the process and focus upon your dreams and what you're here to give and create. Soon you will experience more success than you could ever dream of. Valuing time over money is the 11th habit of self-made millionaires. Have you ever watched The Shark Tank? In short, it's a series on television whereby people can pitch their business ideas to 5 potential millionaire and billionaire investors. Every time the investors evaluate a new business plan, they usually look at how much of their own time they have to invest in the business. They worry about the money part later on. If they have to invest too much time in it, they simply won't invest, even though the business idea might be great. You know, everyone on this planet has a fictional backpack of time on him or her. The thing is, once your amount of time is up, you're dead. And this is the only guarantee that everyone on Earth has. Your tank can be filled with 50, 60, 70, or 80 years, or more or less. The thing is that you don't know when it runs out. You can die tomorrow in an accident, get a heart attack, or you can live to 100 years old, long, happy, and healthy. Wealthy people understand this principle, and they make their time count. This essentially ties in together with most of the principles presented to you in this program. If you value your time over money, you take action now. You practice self-discipline. You have high levels of energy. And you focus on high priority tasks. Do you get the point? People who value money over time want instant gratification. They work for an amount per hour, because they don't want to invest their time into a project or business without an immediate reward. To take this idea even further, you can do a couple of things. First of all, live in the present moment. Wake up earlier, exercise, work out, eat healthy foods, do fun things, work hard, play hard, and do what you want to do. Appreciate the people around you and spend more time with your loved ones. Many people, including myself, have sometimes trouble living in the present. I found that most people focus on the past, a small percentage focuses on the future, and almost no one lives in the present. Read the book The Power of Now for more ideas on the importance of living in the present moment and how to do so. Secondly, don't waste your time and work every time you work. Today's business world is so much focused on trading hours for money. One of my first jobs was as a database manager in an office in Sydney. Everything was focused around time rather than outcomes. Once we knew how much time we had to complete a task, you take that time to complete the task. It is Parkinson's laws, as I said before. So everyone in the office quickly did their work and used the other time to chit-chat, take long breaks, or play games. It is much better to work hard with a clear focus on the outcome for a few hours in the morning than it is to work all day long without focus and distractions. From today onwards, work every time you work. We all have the same hours in a day, and by making those hours count, you put yourself ahead in the game. Finally, stop the need for everything to be perfect. Let me tell you this, I personally believe that a need for perfection is the biggest hurdle people face today on their way to becoming wealthy. And there are a few reasons why. First of all, people who want everything to be perfect realize that this is an enormous task, so 90% doesn't even start. Secondly, because it has to be perfect for them, they will never complete their project, so they will never reap the rewards of what could have been a great project. Thirdly, let's assume the project has been completed and it's perfect, but it's not what the market wants or needs. You'll feel down and uninspired to ever undertake a project again. Automatically, you devalue yourself and you settle for less than you could be. Today's world is changing so rapidly, even if you think it's perfect, you need to constantly innovate and upgrade your skills and knowledge to stay up to date. I recommend you read the book, The Lean Startup, to get some ideas on how you can start a business very quickly from scratch and optimize it along the way. The 12th principle in this program is the need to continuously invest in yourself, in your education. Most people are of the illusion that education is finished after graduation. I would say that your education starts after graduation. Actually, most of what you learn at university and college is theoretical in nature, and often you don't use anything of what you learned. For me personally, I studied business and accounting with subjects like statistics, law, and IT systems. However, I studied during the global financial crisis, and in that time, the governments around the world changed their business and accounting laws. Also, new IT systems were being developed, so the old-fashioned systems that I had to learn are pretty much all obsolete. So I would say 95% of study material from university is pretty much useless, and I have heard similar stories from friends and colleagues. Today's global economy is changing so rapidly, you need to be running to just stay up to date. I would say that the best education you can give yourself is that of personal development. This is the development of you, yourself, to understand yourself and to be completely conscious of your drivers and your motivation. Only you can know this, and it's different for every single person. Invest in your personal development and find out what drives you. Get to know yourself more. You see, most of the people in this world live their lives on autopilot. And I did too until a certain point in my lifetime. I didn't realize it until the shit hits the fan in the form of a major illness, which woke me up. Extremely wealthy people study about their field continuously. Donald Trump is said to study 4 hours a day about personal development. Most writers and speakers research and study continuously to stay up to date in their field. Now, when investing in yourself, it is important to obtain specialized knowledge rather than general knowledge. Learn specialized skills that are useful to you. Read about your field and interest about half an hour to an hour a day, preferably in the morning. It will uplift you, inspire you, and make you more informed than any competitors. Make sure that what you are studying is relevant and up to date. Whenever I personally face a challenge, I find a role model who has been through a similar challenge that what I'm facing. I find out what they did and how they turned their life around. Often their story alone inspires me to do better, and their strategies help me to push through it. Why reinvent the wheel if you can learn from the best? If your business is struggling to find good employees, read books on recruitment. If you struggle to increase your sales, read books on sales, and there are millions of books on these topics. I would also like to add that you have to invest in yourself in the form of time for yourself. Take a couple of days off and go to the beach or hiking or whatever you like. Clearing your mind helps you to connect with yourself, get off the autopilot, and make more aware choices. Finally, use the time you're waiting, such as in the train, at a gym, or in your car, to educate yourself. It doesn't even have to cost much. Most programs are available for a few bucks, and there are also many, many, many free videos available from experts on YouTube. Subscribe to that channel and stay inspired.